For question number 163, the correct option is option 1. Now let's see how we can arrive there. Steps of solution. First of all, note that they are used to different letters for the three different objects. For the sphere, they're using the letter A. For the disc, they're using the letter B. And for the ring, they're using the letter C. Keep this in mind to avoid any silly error. Now, what is the formula for rotational kinetic energy of any body, right? And that formula is, I'm calling it K, and the subscript ROT for rotational. For any body rotating about an axis through its center of mass can be expressed as half into ICM into omega square, where ICM is the moment of inertia of the body about an axis passing through its center of mass. Omega is its angular velocity. In the question they have said all the three objects A, B and C, they have the same angular speed omega. Therefore, keeping this equation in mind, we can write down that for the sphere, rotational kinetic energy is, I'm calling it Ka. I drop the subscript rot and just write Ka for the rotational kinetic energy of the sphere. That will be half into, what is the moment of inertia, ICM, of a sphere? That is 2 by 5 mr square, kept inside brackets, into omega square. The 2's cancelling out, coming out to be 1 by 5 mr square into omega square. Similarly, for the disk, we call rotational kinetic energy as Kb. That will be half into the corresponding value of moment of inertia for a disk. It is half mr square into omega square. This is coming out to be 1 by 4 m r square into omega square. And finally, for the ring, rotational kinetic energy is kc is equal to half into moment of inertia for a ring is simply mr square, kept inside brackets, into omega square, coming out to be half mr square omega square. So you can see here, by comparison, we get quickly that for the ring, kinetic energy kc is the maximum. Then comes rotational kinetic energy of the disk, that is kb, and the smallest kinetic energy is for the sphere. So kc greater than kb greater than k. We already got an order, but the question is to compare the walks required to stop these rotating objects. So if this was my first step of calculation, we are here for the next step, that is step number 2. And in this step, we recall the work energy theorem in the original form that says that the net work done on a body is equal to the change in kinetic energy of the body, delta K, that is K final minus K initial. Now, this is the theorem in general, and in our case, we require the rotational analog of this, which should say that the net work done on a rotating body is equal to the change in the rotational kinetic energy of the body, as in these three cases. Now, in all these three cases, the bodies have to be brought to rest. So if the bodies are eventually brought to rest, final kinetic energy Kf has to be zero, and it's giving me 0 minus Ki, that is equal to minus Ki. I shall write this once again, the rotational analog of work energy theorem, that is the net work to be done on each rotating body will be equal to the negative of the initial kinetic energy of the body. So you understand the work has to be negative here to bring them to rest. So, but the question is telling about the works required to bring them to rest. You understand one thing here. To answer the question, what they really mean is that the work to be done, we take the absolute value or the modulus value of the work. You understand, to bring a rotating body to rest, The work done by agent has to be a negative work, but we are taking the absolute value of that work, and this work has the same magnitude as the initial kinetic energy of the rotating body. So for the sphere, if initial energy is Ka, the work done to bring it to rest, we are calling it Wa. This Wa is negative, whose absolute value I'm calling Wa, that is equal to this Ka, thanks to this expression. If I could improve on this, what I mean is that the negative work has to be done to bring the body to rest, and the absolute value of this must be equal to the initial kinetic energy. Now, keeping this in mind, if we call this absolute value as simply Wa, this work done or required to bring the sphere to rest is numerically equal to Ka. Okay, so this is same as this. Similarly, for the disk, Kb is the rotational energy and the work to be done, absolute value is Wb to bring it to rest. If the ring's energy initially was Kc, this must be the absolute value of the work to be done, that is called Wc, to bring it to rest. So since Kc more than Kb more than Ka, we can write very simply from here by the same logic, Wc greater than Wb greater than Wa. And this gives us a solution, and we choose the option number 1. Let me highlight it, option number 1 is the correct option. I come once again here. Here Wa, Wb and Wc are standing for the absolute value of the negative works to be done on these three rotating bodies to bring them to rest. And depending on the initial kinetic energy, we see that on the ring, maximum work to be done, then on the disc, and the least work to be done on the sphere. And that's option number 1. Understand all these things clearly.